So many people know about the deceitful nesting behaviour of the common cuckoo. So female common cuckoos will forego their parental duties and instead lay their eggs in the nests of another species. We call this behaviour brood parasitism, and species who employ it are called brood parasites. What many people don't realise is that the common cuckoo is just one of over 100 brood parasitic bird species in the world. And our research focused on another group of brood parasites that occurs across most of Africa. And these are the parasitic finches. So this includes the indigo birds and the widers. Each species of indigo birds and each species of wider pretty much lays its egg in the nest of just one species of host. And all of the host species are in this family called the grass finches. Most nestling birds that you come across will be very cryptically coloured. They'll just be sort of dull brown. Whereas these grass finches have elaborate patterns and colours, particularly inside the mouths. And the nestlings of each grass finch species has its own unique characteristic appearance. So our work provided quantitative evidence that these parasitic finches, that their nestlings mimicked the appearance of their specific hosts. And it also never been tested from a bird's visual perspective. Now, this is important because birds see the world differently to us. Birds, for example, have an extra color-sensitive receptor on their retinas that allows them to see an ultraviolet. And also they process pattern in slightly different ways to us. And we also found that they mimicked the begging calls of their specific host, which turn out to be as characteristic for each species as the visual appearance. And finally, we also found qualitative evidence that they mimic the postural movements that the nestling birds make when they're begging for food. So this suggests that these parasitic finches mimic a whole suite of begging-related traits that help ensure that they get sufficient food from their parents. So why is this research important? I think it provides a really compelling example of the power of natural selection to produce truly stunning adaptations. I mean, if you take a look at some of the images of these species, the nestlings have these otherworldly appearances. And you know, for us to really sort of care and love the natural world, we really need to be fascinated by it at a deep level. And I think there's a really important role to be played for these kinds of inspiring stories of the power of evolution in the natural world.